little bit, but York 9, credit them. They were sound defensively. Ingham was solid in goal as well. They knew the result that they needed in this match, and they end up getting it, not giving up more than a goal. They have a tough test. They're looking forward now. Montreal Impact. How do you feel about York 9?
I still think they're a work in progress, and I think they're sort of evolving in the league a little bit. I think this sets them nicely for the game this weekend against Pacific. I think it's still baby steps. I don't think they were really pushed until the last 15 minutes. I think they were still in sort of second gear and in cruise control. And then all of a sudden it was a little bit panic stations at the end when they conceded. But I think from a defensive aspect, Jimmy Brennan will be very happy. And not sort of, okay, they conceded one, but sort of being very comfortable defensively. I think that was important from them. And they had a couple of opportunities. They didn't really commit too many bodies forward on the counter.
What a luxury to have going into an elimination game and, you know, not needing to even attempt a shot on target.
Right.
Zero shots on target. Like I said, the game was the series was won in the first leg. Against Montreal, it's for these CPL sides, I think it's about defining how they want to play. I mean, do you play differently at home than you do away? Do you go in and just set up shop, park the bus, and see if you can get out of there with a goalless in the first leg and then go back to the MLS ground or Ottawa and see if you can nick a goal? How do you set up if you're a CPL side with a significantly less budget playing against superior opposition?
Yeah,
I'd say Montreal is a perfect time to hit Montreal. Montreal's second in the East right now. They're flying. I think their focus is going to be primarily on the league. I think you'll see a mixed bag team against York 9. FC Montreal, the Montreal Impact, they don't play. The second team doesn't play in the USL. So it'll be players not playing regularly. So I think it actually matches up nicely for York 9. I think they'll be motivated. They'll be hungry. There's guys in that squad that have a taste of MLS, so they won't be overawed by the occasion. I love the tie.
Yeah, and what about what they have tactically going forward? Is there enough to score some goals in that tie?
I think Jimmy Brennan, as Kurt sort of touched on, has got a big decision to make. Do you go there and really get after FC Montreal, Montreal Impact, and get right in their faces and press high, almost like they did on opening day against Forge?
Right.
Or do you sit back and look to counter? If it's me, if I'm Jimmy Brennan and I got one of those nice suits on, I'm getting right after the Impact. I think that's what suits York 9, and I don't think the players will want to be shackled.
It's a big picture take, but I think it's just the idea is for these CPL sides to not have to go to the MLS ground and the tie are to be over. So you got to get out of that first leg at home with a decent result.
All right. Well, the third round is set for the Canadian Championship qualifying, and we